Sibley and Yates settle nerves with a solid start.
Last week was deeply damaging for both of these sides. Hampshire came unstuck at the penultimate hurdle, title hopes up in smoke as Kent inflicted a decisive defeat, while Warwickshire slipped up to Gloucestershire and are 14 points from safety. Relegation looms, a positive result is required. The weather pushed the start back until after lunch, Hampshire choosing to start in the field, but the opening exchanges were Warwickshire's to enjoy. The first salvo seen off successfully, and Sibley and Yates built their partnership. The openers saw the 50-up scored from 88 balls and reached when Sibley whipped Holland away for four. It was the nerve-settling start the Bears needed. So much riding on the match, but the opening pair looked serene. Yates would move to his 50 before tea, up to the mark as he flicked Barker's over-pitch delivery away for four. And when they headed in for the break, Warwickshire were up to 95 for none. It wasn't long before the opening stand was worth an unbeaten 100. Up to the mark with a lovely drive back past Wheel from Yates. Sibley two added a boundary, this one off Fuller, moving him to a 50, scored from 105 balls. But finally, after their hosts had put on 129 unanswered runs, Hampshire replied. Sibley outtaken by Donald down the leg side for 54. And Davis followed, bowled first ball by Ian Holland, as the visitors tried to claw back the lost ground. Bad light stopped them from making further inroads. Play brought to a close under darkening clouds, with the score 138 for 2. The solid start they were desperate for had been delivered, but they'd hit their first worrying patch. How they deal with this position could be crucial to their survival chances. The Bears need as many points as they can get. Batting bonus points will be the order of the day and the resumption. Yates hits valiant 100 as rain robs Bears of crucial time. In a season-defining match with the pressure on and a result needed to give themselves a chance of staying in Division 1, Warwickshire produced almost the perfect first day. Sibley and Yates with an unbeaten 100-run opening stand, the only negative, the precious time that had been lost to the weather. Rain again prevented a timely start, but Rob Yates resumed in the same form. Early boundaries moved Warwickshire past 150 as Hayne found his feet. But they were struggling to get going, and their rhythm wasn't helped by the weather. The start delayed, and lunch was taken early. Crucial time taken away from the Bears. The rain stuck around. Warwickshire were again missing out on deeply important time. But when they did finally get back out there, there was reason to be cheerful. Yates up to 100 with two off Fuller. And bonus points added, 200 on the board with two more off Fuller. It was really stop-start stuff. Warwickshire marching off and on, and the disruption saw them slip. Yates bowled by Holland for 104, and Hayne would fall short of his 50, caught behind off Fuller for 44. Rhodes and Moseley tried to make up for lost time, both men batting at a fair rate of knots, 250 up as the number 5 dropped to one knee and slapped Holland away for 4. He lifted him for 6 to the next ball, an expensive over from the Hampshire bowler giving the Bears something to enjoy in the overs before tea. And they reached the break on 272 for 4, coping well considering the repeated disruptions they'd had to endure. The rain once again prevented them building on their platform, and in an attempt to get the game moving, Warwickshire declared during tea. There'd been plenty of encouragement for them with Yates 100, but time was not on their side. The day brought to an end after three Hampshire overs, only four byes added. It's now a straight shootout between the Bears and Yorkshire for the final relegation position, after Kent secured their safety earlier in the day. But Warwickshire are up against it. They need to produce with the ball, force the result, and cross their fingers that Gloucestershire can win at Headingley. Hope, however slim, still remains. Warwickshire set for Kent's final day victory push. Rob Yates picked up his 7th first-class 100 on day 2 at Edgbaston, but it was another day in which the weather had played the most significant part. Warwickshire forced into an early declaration, batting bonus points sacrificed, but faint survival hopes boosted by news that Yorkshire was struggling up at Headingley. With victory a necessity, wickets were a must, so they could have done without Dom Sibley's drop of Ian Holland with the score 6 for none. He got it right the next time though, Organ the man with the edge this time around, first breakthrough for the Bears. And it started to go to plan for Warwickshire. Holland outcaught by Davis off Rhodes. They just about moved past 50 when Weatherly followed. Another catch for Davis, this time off Brooks. And Gubbins would fall for a 10-ball duck, dragging Norwell onto his off stump. They were still yet to bring the 100 up when Ben Brown edged Norwell to Bethel to leave Hampshire 5 down. James Vince ensured that they'd move past three figures before lunch, trailing by 150 at the break. A bit of a regroup was needed. Vince and Donald were positive at the resumption, parity certainly not out of reach for a side of Hampshire's batting talents. They were on show early in the session, as Vince pulled Brooks over the leg side for 6 to move to 50 from 50 balls. Donald was batting just as quickly, 4 off Rhodes moved the partnership to 50 from 48 deliveries. Vince produced a trademark stroke to move Hampshire to 150, a sumptuous cover drive, adding 4 more to his total. They were up to 167 when Donald flicked Brooks to Moseley, a breakthrough at just the right moment. Keith Barker would ensure there was no quick follow-up. He and Vince traded shots and ushered their side past 200. The captain was putting together a wonderful knock and probably deserved 100 for his efforts, but would fall too short, caught behind off Briggs. Fuller and Barker remained through to tee, the deficit down to 30. Warwickshire hopes of a first innings lead were starting to fade. They were erased by Keith Barker, the number 8 taking control of the innings with some big hitting. He reached 50 from 98 balls and ploughed on, Fuller taking the stand to 50 with a single off Rhodes. Barker blasted them past 300, Hampshire now in the lead. But he'd fall for 76, caught by Bethel off Brooks looking for another boundary, a top score of the season for the Hampshire number 8. Wheel wouldn't get off the mark, caught behind off Hammond Albee. And Fuller would leave a bat stranded, caught by Rhodes off Norwell. Hampshire all out for 311, their lead 39. Warwickshire still just about had their heads above water. Norwell pivotal with 4 for 38. Vince majestic for his 98. Had seen the visitors edge in front. The Bears needed to quickly erase the deficit if they were to stay in the game, and they'd almost done so when Yates edged a bat to Vince for 15 to give Hampshire their first breakthrough. And they were still trailing when night watchman Brooks picked out subfielder Tom Prest off Wheel. But Davis and Sibley would move Warwickshire into the lead, past 50 before the close, as Sibley cut Holland away for 4. They'd finish the day on 62 for 2, leading by 23 runs, and still alive. An opportunity had come their way, their destiny now in their own hands, after Yorkshire had slumped to defeat at home to Gloucestershire. The relegation fight goes down to the final day at Edgbaston, and to ensure their survival, Warwickshire have to win, with just 3 sessions remaining. It's going to be a tense final few hours of the LV County Championship for the Bears. Incredible Liam Norwell takes 9 wickets to secure Bears safety. Once again, all eyes are on Edgbaston on the final day of the season. 12 months ago, Warwickshire resumed their second innings and went on to beat Somerset to seal the title. This time, Hampshire are the opponents. Another final day win is necessary, but the prize is safety. Only victory will keep the Bears up. Boundaries were few and far between, but Davis and Sibley took their partnership beyond 50 before Hampshire got the breakthrough. Davis caught by Holland off Wheel for 32, Warwickshire 97 for 3. Sibley moved to 50 from 60 balls before the over was done. More needed, and quickly, if Warwickshire were to force the win. The captain would add a quickfire 13, 6 of them added when he lifted a bass over the boundary, but he'd fall to Wheel, caught by a bass for 13. The Bears were leading by 97 when Moseley tried a big shot, but dragged Fuller on from wide off stump. Bethel would go in Fuller's next over. This was not the showing the Bears needed, down to their last 4 wickets when the number 7 was caught by Weatherly. Sam Hain had been kept down to the firing line, clearly in some discomfort when he did wander out to the middle, but despite his difficulties, he still managed to add a boundary. It was hard to watch though, and brief in the end. Davis called Sibley through for a run, but he wouldn't get there in time. Hain run out for 9 by James Vince. He and his runner walked off. Briggs tried to get them going, 6 added by the spinner, who would eventually fall caught in the leg side off Fuller, who dealt with Norwell with the very next delivery. The tail ender bowled, the Bears down to their final wicket. And Sibley was the last to go, LBW to Holland's Yorker, out for 77. Warwickshire were all out for 177, meaning to win the game and stay in Division 1, they'd have to defend a target of 139 and take 10 wickets in the process. But there was hope at the resumption. Felix Organ out caught behind off Hammond Albee with just 6 on the board. And when Holland left Norwell to clatter into his off stump, this was the start the Bears needed. They were in the hunt. Weatherly, LBW for 10 for another to Norwell. Vince and Gubbins set Warwickshire hearts aflutter. The required runs dropped into double figures. But the hosts hit back, the all-too-threatening Hampshire captain out caught in the deep by Hannon Dalby as Norwell kept up his momentum. Ben Brown joined Nick Gubbins, the pair careful but chipping away at the target, and before long they'd reached the halfway point and Warwickshire were running out of time. You could sense the relief when Brown went LBW to Norwell for 11, but was it too late for them now? They'd have to find out after tea. Hampshire, 61 runs away at the break. Warwickshire desperate for 5 more wickets. The target was 53 away when Norwell struck again to take his 5th wicket. Donald outcaught by Bethel for 12. In came former Bear Keith Barker, but even he couldn't stop Norwell. Stumps left in a mess as he was bowled for 4, Norwell's 10th in the match. The target wasn't far away now, and Fuller made a bright start. Dot balls hard to come by, wicket-taking opportunities even rarer. Gubbins moved into the 40s. The match was drifting from Warwickshire, the required runs down into the teens. But when it looked like all hope was lost, Norwell kept them alive. Gubbins, LBW for 46, just 2 more wickets required. Again, it looked like Warwickshire were dead and buried. But once again, Norwell hauled them out of the flames. Fuller bowled for 22. Q. Pandemonium. Abbas lasted 3 balls, the great escape pulled off thanks to one of the great Warwickshire bowling performances. Liam Norwell finished with 9 for 62. It had been a simply stunning day of cricket. Emotions overflowing in the middle as "You Bears" echoed around Edgbaston. It was the most improbable feat. They'd looked finished before the game and repeatedly throughout the match, but they'd pulled it off at the 11th hour. Yorkshire relegated in their place, and Liam Norwell had almost done it by himself. Sibley 2 key with the bat on his final appearance for Warwickshire. County cricket is alive and well. Scintillating stuff brought the curtain down on another stunner of a season in the LV County Championship.